Speak Up English, the key to success.
Sarah, have you ever thought about starting your own successful business? It sounds like the dream, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely, David. Being your own boss, pursuing your passion, and calling the shots, it's like the ultimate adventure. But where do you even begin?
Haha, great question, Sarah. It's like standing at the edge of a forest, wondering which path to take. First, you need a solid idea, something that excites you.
Rue, David. Your business idea is like the North Star, it guides you. But then comes the tricky part, turning that idea into a plan. Any tips for that?
Well, Sarah, it's like planning a road trip. You need a map, a business plan outlining your goals, target audience, and how you'll make money. It's like plotting stops on your journey.
Haha, a road trip analogy. I like it, David. But you know, not all businesses make it. What's the secret sauce for success?
Sarah, that's the million-dollar question. It's like baking a cake. You need the right ingredients, hard work, dedication, adaptability, and a pinch of luck.
Haha, a cake recipe for business success. And I guess you also need to keep an eye on the competition, right?
Absolutely, Sarah. Business is like a game of chess. You need to anticipate your opponent's moves. But remember, it's not always about crushing the competition. Sometimes, collaboration is key.
Good point, David. Collaboration can be like a booster rocket for your business. So, once you're up and running, how do you stay motivated?
Well, Sarah, it's like fueling your car. You need regular doses of inspiration and a passion for what you're doing.
Haha, staying motivated with a full tank. And I suppose managing finances is crucial too, right?
You got it, Sarah. Managing money is like steering your ship. Keep a close eye on your expenses and revenue. It's the compass that keeps you on course.
Haha, a ship at sea. So, David, what's the most important lesson you've learned on your business journey?
Well, Sarah, it's like learning to ride a bike. You might stumble, but don't give up. Every failure is a lesson, and perseverance is your training wheels.
That's a great perspective, David. Perseverance as the training wheels of success. So, for all the aspiring entrepreneurs out there, what's your message?
Keep dreaming, keep learning, and keep taking those steps, no matter how small they seem. Starting your own business is like writing your own adventure story.
Well said, David. Let's inspire some future business tycoons out there. And with that, we conclude our conversation on how to start your own successful business.
Part 2. Sarah, starting a successful business is like embarking on a grand expedition. Along the way, You'll encounter challenges, but it's how you tackle them that defines your journey.
I couldn't agree more, David. It's like climbing a mountain. The view from the top is amazing, but the climb itself is where you grow and learn. And speaking of challenges, what's one you've faced in your entrepreneurial journey?
Well, Sarah, one big challenge was finding the right team. Building a team is like forming a fellowship on a quest. You need people who share your vision and complement your skills.
Haha, a fellowship indeed, David. And having a supportive team can make the journey much more enjoyable. But what about marketing your business? Any secrets there?
Marketing is like waving a flag on your ship. You want people to notice you, right? It's all about understanding your target audience and finding creative ways to connect with them.
Ahoy, Captain David. Sailing the seas of marketing. And speaking of connections, networking must be crucial in the business world, right?
Absolutely, Sarah. Networking is like gathering allies in your adventure. Attend events. Join industry groups and make genuine connections. You never know who might become your Gandalf.
Haha, Gandalf. The wise mentor you didn't expect. And as your business grows, do you ever worry about work-life balance?
Oh, that's a tough one, Sarah. Balancing work and life is like juggling flaming torches. It takes practice, but it's essential to avoid burnout.
Juggling flaming torches, a skill every entrepreneur should master. And, David, have you ever faced a moment when you thought your business might not make it?
Oh, Sarah, there were moments when it felt like sailing through a storm. But every setback is like a thunderclap. It reminds you to adjust your sails and keep moving forward.
Adjusting sails in a storm, that's resilience right there, David. And you know, you've shared some great insights today. What's your advice for someone on the verge of starting their own business?
I'd say, have a clear vision, a solid plan, and the determination of a dragon slayer. It's like forging a powerful sword. You'll need it on your quest for success.
A dragon slayer's determination, I love it, David. To all the future entrepreneurs out there, may your businesses flourish like legendary adventures.
Well said, Sarah. May their entrepreneurial journeys be filled with triumphs and tales worth telling. And with that, we conclude our conversation on starting and growing a successful business.